Hey everybody, Stephen Bogren here from Pro Physique. Today I'm going to talk about protein pairing and considerations for your protein intake as a plant-based dieter. People and things, man, what a mouthful. Protein pairing considerations, plant-based, that's a lot. But if you clicked on the video, you already know how important protein can be for our fitness goals. Not only for fitness goals in terms of I want to look great, I want to feel great, but how about also I want to perform great. I want to be at my true best. And we need protein to do so, simply based on the fact that guess what? All these performance muscles, all this, maybe not these ones, but it's made of protein. I mean, these ones are still made of protein, but they might not perform as well as they used to. So it's super duper important that we're aware of what that means, particularly as a plant-based athlete. Now, let me be very frank. I can't be frank, I'm Steven. But I digress. It is very, very important as a plant-based athlete to make sure that your protein intake is on point. Reasons being, not all proteins are created equal, and it can be very easy to have a diet that might be reasonably high in protein still, but not there on complete protein. So the first thing that I want to talk about today is complete proteins. When we talk about getting enough protein, really what we mean is enough complete protein. And so what you will see here is a list of the essential amino acids. And this is what we are referring to when we are talking about a complete protein. There are a lot of amino acids. Some of them are non-essential, meaning at any point in time, if our body needs it, it can synthesize it and make it from within. Some of them are conditionally essential, which means depending on where we're at, depending on what we have available, we can make those and we don't need to eat them from an outside source. The last one, and this is what we're talking about with our essential amino acids. Our bodies cannot synthesize these, which means we have to get them from an outside source. What does that mean, Steven? That's a lot. Okay, I get it. A lot of plant proteins will be what we call incomplete, which means they will have some of the essential amino acids, but they will not have all of them. In this case, what we have to do is we have to look at ways to combine and pair our food choices to have complete proteins. And that would be probably the more difficult one. Obviously, we can utilize other sources of plant-based proteins that are maybe complete, something like seitan or tofu, pea protein isolate. There are plenty of options out there. Now, it is a little bit more limited. There aren't quite as many options because there's a lot of stuff off the table, pun intended. That is okay, and it doesn't mean that we have to be at any disadvantage here. We simply have to pay attention. And that might mean that we supplement with protein a little more often, and that might be something that we do, and that can be an absolute way to address and fix our protein needs, making sure that we are getting adequate, complete proteins there. Or we can really do a mixture of both, and that's probably what most people are gonna wanna do, is a mixture of protein pairings as well as possible supplementation to make sure that they are meeting their protein goals. Now, what your protein goal should be will be different based on each individual. And I can put some outlines down here of what we tend to see. What we would see for most individuals and our regular protein recommendations would be low for most athletic populations. Athletic populations are going to most likely need a higher protein intake. So when we keep that in mind and we understand how to do so, There is zero reason as a plant-based athlete, you, I, anyone else, cannot perform just as well. So we want to be aware of that. With that in consideration, understanding that we have to get enough complete proteins and we have to maybe pair and look at amino acids, and there might be a little bit more homework and a learning curve there to really get that protein intake where it needs to be. We also want to be aware of how proteins digest, because not all proteins are created equal in terms of digestion, how your body breaks down that food and retrieves the amino acids and nutrients from it. So we do want to keep that in consideration as well. And with that in consideration, what I'll do is I'll a protein digestibility score. These are just random foods, and you'll see some of them are not vegan. But it just proves the point that we might want to be aware also of the types of proteins that we are choosing to pair and get our protein needs met from when utilizing a plant-based dietary approach. Again, there is nothing wrong with this. You are not at any kind of disadvantage. Anybody who tells you otherwise, I would say, would be incorrect. We just need to pay attention and understand the same basics of nutrition, but how to apply them within the plant-based nutrition realm. Again, supplementation really probably going to be most people's go-to, or finding higher protein options that have complete proteins. Again, soy, tofu, seitan, to name a few. The hard part about that last point I want to make is that we also have to make those complete protein options fit within our macronutrient and calorie goals. And so when we look at things like tofu, which can be higher in fat, if we're eating a lot of tofu, that can sometimes make it difficult to meet protein requirements while staying within your calorie requirements, say if you're in a dieting or deficit, trying to get leaner. And that might change what we do to meet those requirements. Again, this is where things like supplementation can come into play. There are plenty of options in terms of pea protein isolates and vegan protein options that we can all look at. Again, I do think it makes sense to, before we say, cool, vegan protein, click, good to go, we look at our protein or our amino acid profile, because of the fact that, again, just because it's a vegan protein does not mean that it's going to suit our needs in terms of complete proteins. So we do want to make sure that it has all of those essential amino acids. That's going to be our big one first and foremost. We do also want to make sure that it has a decent amount of leucine. When it comes to our essential amino acids for muscle building, leucine does seem to carry a little bit more weight and clout in terms of telling our body to make new muscle than maybe some of the other ones. Do we need them all? Yes, we still want our complete protein profiles. However, leucine is a big one to look out for and to keep an eye on. We want to make sure that we're getting enough of it. Without going through all of the science behind it and the chemistry, leucine does look to be like a big factor in saying, make muscle. And the reason protein is so important is because, and I'll say it again and again, thanks Dr. Campbell, it is what I like to refer to as the adaptive macronutrient, meaning when we eat enough complete proteins in a sitting, and that's going to be based on our lean body mass, our body says, hey, I'm going to trigger new muscle growth. I'm going to start building the strong. Nothing else does that. Carbohydrates, they do help prevent muscle protein breakdown, for sure. And so that can absolutely be beneficial. And one of the reasons why we want to include carbohydrates in our diets. Plant-based, not a problem. But it does not do the same thing that protein does. So we want to be very aware of that. Plant-based diets can absolutely offer us a ton of benefits. It's obviously going to be much easier when we're eating a lot of vegetables and unprocessed foods to make sure that we are getting a full spectrum of micronutrients. We're also going to have a higher fiber intake, which is going to be great for some other health markers as well as our digestive health. So I do think there are a ton of benefits beyond any belief systems that you might have influencing you. However, I do want to encourage you that as a plant-based athlete, you can do everything that you want to do. All we have to do sometimes is pay a little attention to the details.